Hello student, today we are going to understand one more topic related with our computer subject of standard 4th. So our today's topic is how to manage our desktop, that is desktop management. So let I explain you that desktop is your front screen of your PC. That is called a desktop. And today in this chapter, we are going to understand how to manage the things available on the desktop. So now student, first of all, we will understand that what is the things available on our desktop. This is the thing that you are watching on your screen. It's a desktop. This entire screen is called a desktop. And few icons are available, like owner is written, that is the icon, computer, recycle bin, new folder, emblaze, Adobe Reader, Quick Hill, and Firefox. These all are the icons available on the desktop. You can see one arrow is also attached with this four of the things. This shows the sign of shortcut. That means when you click on this, you can able to open the desirable thing that you want. Like if you want to click Quick Hill Antivirus. So if you click on this directly, you can open your Quick Hill Antivirus. So it will create a shortcut from where you can able to directly access your desirable thing. That is why we make a shortcut of certain thing on desktop. Next, we have at the bottom of the desktop, you can see a line is given, that is called a taskbar. This line, this one, where you can see start menu is there, then few browser is there, and then few more icons are present. At the right corner, you can see time and date is given. So this bar is called a taskbar. So now student, we are going to understand few more things about the taskbar. We are going to understand this long horizontal bar at the bottom of the desktop is called the taskbar. About that only we are going to understand few things which is available on your desktop. I already said that start button is there, then we have folder, few applications icon are also there, like browser and word. These all are called application icons. Then you have a speaker button over here. Then you have some more notification area is there. And at the end, you can see time and date is present. So I hope student, you have understood what is a taskbar. Now we will see that how can we able to customize the taskbar. So the first step that we are going to use for customizing our taskbar, that is moving the taskbar. Okay, so in this practical experiment, in this practically we are going to move our taskbar. For that, what we have to do, the first step is right click on a blank area on the taskbar and select the properties option. As you can able to see on your screen, when you click right click on the desktop, you can able to see this dialog box, this one, this dialog box you can able to see on your screen, and then you have to click on the properties. As you click on the property, second step is that you can able to see this dialog box, that is called a taskbar and start menu properties. Okay, in that one more dialog box is there, that is taskbar tab, that you have to select it. This is this taskbar. And step three is what? Select the desired location from the drop down menu present under taskbar location on the screen, then click the apply button or OK button. So here it is, taskbar location is given on the screen, then you have to click on the desirable thing wherever you want the taskbar to be present on your desktop. And then you have to click apply and press OK. So you can able to see the taskbar is moved from one place to another wherever you have placed it. Now student, we'll do this thing practically. Okay. To do, first of all, you have to right click on the desktop. So I am doing right click on the desktop. I got this dialog box. Okay, then we have to click on personalize, the last option of this box, personalize. As you click on this, you will get this kind of screen on your desktop. Okay, then you have to click taskbar and start menu. As you click taskbar and start menu, you can able to see one more box on your screen. There you have to click on taskbar location on screen. So here we have an option bottom. You can able to select wherever you want, like left, right, top. These are the four options that you can able to see on your screen. Right now, taskbar location is on the bottom side. So you can see here it is in the bottom. Now I want to change the position of the taskbar. So you can able to click any one of the option among this four. Right now I am clicking top. And then what you have to do, you have to click OK. So now student, you can see the taskbar is disappeared from the bottom side and now it is available on the top side of my screen. You can able to see the top side of the screen, it is there. So student, I think you have understood this much, how to move the taskbar according to your preference. So student, I hope you have understood this practically, how to move the taskbar according to your preference. And you have four options, that is bottom, left, right, and top. Okay. Now we are going to understand how to lock the taskbar. That is, locking the taskbar prevents it from being resized or moved to a different position on the desktop. Understood? Locking means you will lock the taskbar, and because of that, taskbar will not be able to move or will not be able to resize to different position or to different size on the desktop. So let me understand how it can be possible. First of all, we will go through the presentation, then we will do a practical. So steps for locking the taskbar. First step, right click an empty area of the taskbar and select the properties option. Okay, as we did earlier. And then second step, the taskbar and start menu properties dialog box appear. Select the taskbar tab. Okay, then third step, that is already given on the screen, a dialog box is there. You have to click on the lock the taskbar. Third step is what? Click the lock the taskbar option and click apply button or select OK. Understood? We have one more way of locking the taskbar, that is right click an empty area of the taskbar and click the lock the taskbar option. This is the second way we can lock our taskbar. So I hope student you have understood this much. Now we are going to do practically this two method. Now student, we are going to do practically how to move the taskbar or how to resize it. That can be locked with the help of now student, we are going to understand how to lock the taskbar so that it can prevent it from moving the taskbar or from resizing the taskbar. First of all, we'll see without locking, can I be able to resize the taskbar? So let's do it. So So I'm just pressing and dragging it to. Now, student, you can see that I have resized the taskbar. And we did it because I haven't locked the taskbar. That is why I have changed the size of the taskbar. So now, to lock the taskbar, what we have to do, you have to click a right button of the mouse and you will get this dialog box. Then you have to click on personalize. You will get this kind of window again. Then on that you have to select taskbar and start menu. Then you will get a box on your screen and there you have one option, that is lock the taskbar. What is that? Lock the taskbar. You have to tick that one. Understood what option you have to select? Lock the taskbar. Then you have to click on OK button. Now, student, we have locked our taskbar. So now you can see that I am not able to drag this taskbar and not able to resize the taskbar as I locked the taskbar. That is why. Now, by one more method, we can do this thing, that is locking of taskbar. Then you have to click on the taskbar. You have to click on the taskbar, right click on the taskbar. Then you have to select lock the taskbar. As we have already did it, that is why this tick button is there. If I want to again unlock the taskbar, I have to uncheck this box. And now you can see that, student, again I can able to change the size of the taskbar. So this is the second method that we can able to do. I hope, student, you have understood how to lock the taskbar, the two methods. Now, student, we are going to understand another thing, that is hiding the taskbar. The taskbar is normally visible at the bottom of the desktop screen. You can hide it and show it only when the mouse pointer is moved at the bottom edge of the screen. So hiding the taskbar, that means it is only visible when you move your cursor or the pointer of the mouse near to that. Then only it can be able to visualize. Otherwise, in the normal time, it will be in the hiding position. How we can do this practically? First of all, we learn it from the presentation. The steps for hiding the taskbar. What we have to do, the first step is select the taskbar tab from the taskbar and start menu property dialog box. And second step, check auto hide the taskbar option and click the apply button or select OK. So student, now we are going to do this practically, okay? So student, what we have to do, we have to first click on the desktop, the right click of the mouse and then press personalize. Then you will get this kind of box on your screen. You have to click on task and start menu. One more dialog box will appear on your screen. There you have one option that is called auto hide the taskbar. Auto hide the taskbar. That box you have to tick. And then you have to press on apply. As you click on apply and OK, you have to press it. Now, student, you can see that my taskbar was actually present on the top of my screen, but now it is not. And at the bottom, it is not. Now I want to just move my cursor near to it. Look, as I bring my cursor near to that desktop, it automatically appear on the screen. Otherwise, if I remove my pointer from the taskbar, it will again disappear. Look, student, so I hope you have understood that how we have disappeared the desktop and how it can be reappear as we bring our mouse pointer near to it. Like it is visible on the screen. Now, if I remove my pointer from the taskbar, it will again disappear. I hope, student, you have understood the different tasks that is performed on taskbar, like hiding, moving, or disappearing, or changing the position of the taskbar. That we all can able to do. I hope, student, you can do this practically on your own PC. Thank you, student, for watching this video.